House cats are good at a few things. Mostly sleeping, destroying things, and starring in countless hours of online videos. But can they swim? We probably all have an opinion on this important question, and some of us, unfortunately, have directly experienced a cat coming into contact with water. For a scientist, however, such questions are best answered by applying what is known as the scientific method. The first step in the method is to propose a correct answer, which is also the most cautious one. Cats cannot swim. This is called the null hypothesis. Null means nothing, or zero. The next step is to collect evidence, in a systematic way, to test the hypothesis. We can either reject the null hypothesis, or fail to reject it. Yes, this is a negation of a negation, but remember, scientists are cautious. The simplest way to test whether cats can swim would be to toss about 100 of them, one at a time and on separate occasions, into a pool of water. Of course, if any of the cats failed to swim, we'd rescue them before they came to any harm. Anything less would be unethical. Fortunately for science, the internet hosts a lot of videos about cats, more than 1 million on YouTube alone, and it looks like some cats actually can swim. However, if you divide the number of swimming cat videos by all the cat videos on YouTube, you see them swimming in less than 1%. In any case, we now have multiple pieces of data, videos of cats swimming in deep water, to provide evidence in support of rejecting the null hypothesis. Does this mean that cats can definitely swim? After all, those videos could have been faked. Direct and humane observation of many cats may be the best way to answer this question. So, we suggest if you really want to know if cats can swim, you spend as much time as possible watching them amble, paddle, and sleep their way through their days. For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, I'm Yasmin Tayegh.